it if you'll just share it. Amen. If you'll get your candle that you've barely been keeping lit, you hide it under a bushel, but every now and then you raise the bushel up just to get enough oxygen to keep it going. You go to church on Sunday morning, get a little oxygen for it. You go to church on Wednesday night or Tuesday night, get a little oxygen for it. Rest of the time you keep it hid. Amen. It's time you got the candle out. Put it on the candlestick and let it shine before men. You are the light of the world. He said, let your light so shine. I'll give you that scripture. Say, Brother Billy, surely Jesus didn't tell us to do that. Matthew 5, 14, 15, and 16. He said, you're the light of the world. A city that is set on a hill cannot be hid. Neither do men light a candle and put it under a bushel, but on a candlestick, and it giveth light unto all that are in the house. Let your light so shine before men that they may see your good works and glorify your Father which is in heaven. Amen. God has provided. God has provided. You have found salvation today. If you're saved, if you're born again, everyone in here that I see is. You have the answer. People say, I just don't know what we'll do. I don't know what the answer is. We do. The answer is Jesus. Always has been, always will be. Turn to Jesus. Amen. He has the answers for your hurting soul. All we have to do is share it with them. Quit hiding it. Quit hiding it. We've got the key to the end of the famine, Sister Nancy. We've got the one that can provide for their sin, sick, and hurting souls. Yet like these four old lepers began to do at the first. They grabbed it up. Oh, we found it now. Let's take it over here and let's hide it. Amen. That's what we do, Brother Bill. Say, well, I don't do no such thing. How many times have you, like a turtle, sunk back in your shell and didn't witness for Jesus because you're afraid of what somebody'd think? That hits hard this morning. I hope it ain't for you in here. I hope it's for those listening by radio or what, or listening to this over the internet. How many times have we not let people know? Amen. Somebody came to a camp meeting and they got saved. A lumberjack worked way back up in the hills with a bunch of old rough guys. Came and got saved at the camp meeting. And the preacher thought, he's going to have a rough time now. He's going to back up everything, guys. Them guys cuss like sailors. They're a rough bunch of fellas. They fight amongst themselves, drink when they ain't working. So we went back up in the hills, and a few months later they had another camp meeting. The old lumberjack came down, came to the camp meeting, and the preacher said, well, I bet you've been having a rough time of it. He said, what do you mean? He said, damn old boys, you went back up there saved. You went back up there a Christian. You've been having a rough time of it. He said, no. I just didn't let them know anything happened. They couldn't tell anything different. More likely, you didn't get it. Amen. You either got it, you hid it, and you lost it. You got your light lit. You hid it under a bushel, and it went out. Try that experiment sometime. Take your candle, light it, and hide it under a bucket. Lift it up and see if it's still lit. Got to have air. Got to have oxygen. Amen. Them old lepers, they got convicted. I pray to God that the church gets convicted. Amen. And has to go back and say, oh, I can't handle this. Give me this. I got to take his and I got to share it with somebody. Here's what you need. That's what you got to have. You got to have this. Let me tell you about what this did for me. Let me tell you what Jesus did for me. You got to have Jesus. I know you don't have no peace. It looks like everything's going bad, but you got to have this. This is what I found. This is what you need. This is your answer. Instead of taking it and hiding it, share it with somebody, Sister Nancy. Amen. Share it with somebody. I got a few people here in town don't even know. I don't know who they are, and I don't think they know my name. They just call me preacher. That's good, but I want it to be more than a few, Brother Bill. Amen. I want it to be more than a few. I want everybody around to know that I know Jesus. Hallelujah. I don't care if they know I'm a preacher. I don't care if they know that I sing. I don't care any of that stuff. I just want them to know that I know Jesus. Amen. Hallelujah. I've had people come up to me in the store and ask me to pray for them. Why? Not because I'm good, because I got Jesus. They've probably done the same thing for some of you folks, and they'll do the same thing more often. If we'll let our light shine and let them know that we got something different than what the world has, we've got what they're looking for, they'll come running to you and say, pray for me, I need something. They need Jesus. Stop hiding him. Amen. Time we got Jesus out the closet. Amen. It's time we quit hiding him under a bushel. And say, hey, guess what? Do you know Jesus as your Lord and Savior? Yeah, but Brother Billy, I'm too shy. Yeah, but today I saw a face in the flames. Folks I had worked with, been around for years, if I'd have told them about Jesus, might not be there. Let's share what we got. Amen. God used these four old lepers. They first thought they was going to hide it, but they couldn't. And they grab it up. They run into the city and they share it with them. And God's word comes to pass that the famine is over. The famine is over. The answer has came. That's what we need to be telling the world. Amen. Some of them still looking for the Messiah. They need to know he done came. He was born in a stable in Bethlehem. Came forth out of the womb of a virgin by the name of Mary. Amen. A lot of the Jews, they're still looking for their coming Messiah. They're still looking for him to be born. He's already been born. Amen. He's done been born. He's been crucified. He raised from the grave. And he's getting ready to come back again. Amen. Call his people up out of here. Hallelujah. Let's share him. Share him with the world while we got time. Don't hide it. Don't hide it under a bushel. Amen. Hallelujah. I can tell that every one of y'all are so fired up and on fire, you're fixing to run out these doors and sharing with everybody you see. Hallelujah. Someone else have something this morning before we go. God is so good, and that's an understatement. I know that.